Sometimes in City Skylines, you might have this situation where you have an intersection, where you have a main avenue road and some kind of a tram line that needs to split from it. But as you can see, it's not really working very well by default because it has the vanilla traffic lights set up. And ideally, you might want to give the trams some kind of a priority green light. So that's exactly what I'm going to show you in this video. And I'm also going to just treat this intersection so it looks slightly better. I'm going to be using the node controller for improving the shape of the intersection. Then the intersection marking tools to just paint some lines, make it just look better, and of course for the functionality, the traffic manager. Now it's important if you are going to do any kind of changes to the shape of the intersection with the node controller to do it first. So I'm for example going to take a look at this segment in here. I'm going to slightly increase the corner offset, and also in this one, because it's nicely going to not really straighten, but just improve the shape of the tracks. Let's go into the traffic manager, because this is the entire point of this process. I'm going to go into the timed traffic lights. I'm going to click the node here, and I'm going to set up timed traffic lights. Now, this is only going to take two steps. The first step is going to have minimum time of 1, and the maximum time is going to be just some random really big number. Now I'm going to click someone is waiting, so basically it's going to trigger every time the waiting is above 0, but even, just to be sure, I'm just going to click the sensitivity to be the slider to be the highest. Now I'm going to make it for this first step so that cars have green from both sides, but the trams have red. I'm going to add it. The second step is going to be minimum time. Let's maybe start with 3 seconds, okay? But this might be something that you have to experiment with based on the size of the intersection. The minimum time is basically the time it takes for the tram to fully clear the intersection so that you don't have the vehicles just ramming into the end of the tram after, it triggers back into the first step, okay? Now the maximum time, let's just make it like double the minimum time, okay? The maximum time is there so that you kind of limit some problems when you have 2 trams going into the intersection from both sides, but they are not exactly going to meet at the right time, okay, at the same time. Now in here we can just keep it at more waiting than driving, and we can just keep the flow sensitivity too high. But of course we must not forget to change the lights. Now in here I'm just going to switch these at the front, and I'm going to put these to green, okay, so the trams. Now the direction for the cars that is not crossing the tracks, that's obviously going to remain green because those cars can just go uninterrupted. Now these kinds of situations, I usually do it without the crosswalks, but if you were doing crosswalks in here and allowed pedestrians to cross, then you might want to do the crossing obviously in the second time and just raise these minimum times so that pedestrians have enough time to just do the crossing, okay? So I'm going to add it and I'm going to start it, and that's basically it. So as you can see, every time a tram is even approaching the intersection, it's immediately going to trigger the change in the phase so that the trams are basically not even slowing down, or maybe just slightly. Now you might encounter some issues, and it might be something like the second phase does not have enough minimum time so that it triggers back to cars way too soon. But as you can see, the 3 seconds in this particular case is more than enough, and it's working just fine. I'm going to show you a couple of examples that I built in my Aurelia city, for example, where I used this technique, and it's working really, really well. And after we are done with the functionality, you can use the intersection marking tools to paint some lines around the intersection, and maybe if you want to, you can just get rid of these vanilla wires and just detail in your own, so they actually go over the tracks and just look better. Anyway, that's going to be all. Thank you for watching. Hopefully this was useful to you, and I will see you in the next one.